That has been actually mentioned.
Presidential appointments and deployments, and which are effective immediately. The president has appointed the following. Vice President Senator Engineer Muzuri remains Vice President. Senator Komichi, previously the chairperson of the party, is now appointed Vice President. Professor Watchman Nube is appointed Vice President. Honorable Tavita Kumalo is redeployed to become Vice National President. Chairperson. And Honorable Tendai Biti, Professor Watchman Nube is appointed Vice General remains President. Honorable Monzora, Deputy Honorable General remains Tavita Kumalo is redeployed to become Vice National Chairperson. The list, the full list of these appointments is exhaustive and very long, and we're not going to go through all that. I'm going to look at an important appointment the president has met with relation to local government. After meeting with the leaders of local councils yesterday, where he discussed issues or addressed issues of cholera and typhoid, he has tasked local council to speed up prevention activities, but is deeply concerned that central government has not yet declared the crisis as a state of emergency in order to allow resources to be pulled together. The president is focused on making sure that our councils are effective and work in accordance with his smart policies and programs. Thus, the president has made an appointment of an almost ministerial level secretary for government and devolution. And this this is to make sure that our local authorities are run effectively. Appointed to this position is Mr. Cecil Zizai, who is going to be the Secretary for Local Government and Devolution. And the President emphasizes that for him it's an important appointment and that the work is cut out for his team. He has also appointed Mr. Clifford Thatchwire as the Deputy Secretary for Local Government and Devolution. Another notable appointment is the Secretary for Constitutional and Parliamentary Affairs, Honorable Itaita Pulu. The President has also appointed committee members to the to his team. He has appointed Maureen Kademaunga as a committee member, Gladys Thatcher as a committee member, Honorable Settlement Chikwinya, Honorable Mshoriwa, Honorable Miriam Mushai, and Rita Ndovu as committee members. He's also appointed Ngobizi Tamlilo and Evelyn Masaiji as committee members. Do we have anybody else? Or was it all the committee members? Look, what we're going to do is that we're going to provide you with a full list of the appointments so that you can have a look at the names that you're interested in. But what was important was to outline those that are in top leadership and also to outline, to point out for you those who have been redeployed or those who have been deployed from our from the Alliance members. So what is important here is that the MDC has finally gone back to its original strength. President Nelson Chamisa made it his commitment at the beginning that the party would rebuild, galvanize, and prepare to run this country as effectively as possible. And he has begun this process. As you can see, what used to be many factions of the MDC is no longer that. You now have a unified movement for democratic change. You're going to see it grow from strength to strength. There are other appointments made that I think that I will leave to the new spokesperson for the party to make in relation to Parliament.
Yes, they are parliamentary appointments. Some of them will probably are part of the nomination process, so we will not go through them. We'll go to the ones that we are in control. The leader for the opposition in the House of Assembly will be Honorable Tabitha Kumalo, deputized by Honorable Kim Pariwa. The leader of the opposition in Senate will be Honorable Engineer Mutsuri, deputized by Senator Morgan Komichi. The chief whip in Senate will be Senator Tim Vios, deputized by Senator Sina Mupande. And then the chief whip of the House of Assembly will be, for the opposition, will be Honorable P. Mutseyami, deputized by Honorable N. Zov. Those are the appointments as relates to our presence in both houses of Parliament, as it were.
All right, thank you so much for that lovely presentation. So we'll take any questions that you may have. Yes.
Robert, I wanted to find out, we have said the original members have not come there to the formation of the integration. Is effort made to Tobozani Kupe's team?
As you know, the MDC Alliance had its members, and efforts were made at different stages to bring every genuine member of the opposition to come and join in the big tent that we created as we're going to the elections. So sufficient effort was made, and we think that, as you have seen, Tobozani Kupe is leaning the other way. So certainly, that's the position. Sufficient effort was made. I mean, you will remember that part of the reason she was the alliance. She didn't like the alliance at all. Didn't like coming back.
Probably, it goes of the way the alliance. Now that same original members are coming together, maybe it's a question of weight. She didn't like the alliance, but having one of the original members of MDC. After the elections, has there been made some efforts to reach out to them?
After the election?
Yeah.
The resolution to integrate the party was met before the elections.
Thank you so much. Any other question? Okay, thank you.
Okay,
and Chidza, so.
My name is Leopold Mundi with Music Award. My question is on the immigration, which is said to go on now this weekend. Can you give us more details on that?
Okay, can we take two more questions?
Maybe, yeah, Chidza, if you could probably elaborate, you indicate that Tobozani Kupe is heading the other way. Which way?
Okay, yeah. Definitely we have other political parties maybe that contested this election independently outside the alliance. Now that you're reaching out to the original members of the MDC, Are these members welcome to join SHIP, or what is the position?
The main focus of the weekend activities is the anniversary. The MDC is turning 19. We are going to take stock of the road that we've traveled for the past 19 years. We are going to take stock of the victory that we obtained in the last presidential election, or the recent presidential election. And in that score, we are going to have a set of activities that we are going to undertake on that particular day. And we invite all of you to come and see what will happen on the day. But one must remember that the focus of our activity on the weekend is to celebrate our 19th anniversary. And what is in the program will be on the program on the day.
With regards to Tawazani Kupe going the other way, look, the fact of the matter is that a lot of outreach was carried out, and that it looks like her mind was made up. But that goes hand in hand with the question around anybody who wishes to join SHIP. Look, President Nelson Chamisa has made it very clear, and you can see that it's beginning that process that a lot of people thought was perhaps impossible, to bring back the MDC, to bring different political people with different political aspirations together. He's doing this successfully. He's doing a great job. If anything, the fact that Tawazani Kupe isn't part of the MDC is an exception to the rule that proves the rule, that he can bring everybody in. Okay, and that in real life you're going to have those that that want to go the other way. There's only one way to effectively oppose this dictatorship. It is to make sure that the opposition is as united as possible. And the president is interested in that. And he has done what hasn't been done in this country. He has managed to, every time ZANU-PF split up, it never really rejoined. In the history of this country, that's the first time that you have a major political party bringing back its members, its leadership, having those people bury the hatchet and try to move forward. So I think we're doing great, and Tawazani Kupe proves the rule, proves the general rule.
Okay, we'll take you and anything.
Maybe you can clarify more on the legal perspective and what the Constitution says with regard to going to the Congress first before such appointments are made. Because Zimbabwe out there are questioning why the appointments are being done before the Congress.
Okay.
I wanted to find out what it is now to the court case where Tukuzan Kupu was taken to court over the use of the name in the law.
All right.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Our constitution provides for various powers that the president has, that the National Council has in between the Congress. Now you will notice that there were legal steps taken by the President. Firstly, in terms of the current Constitution, our President is mandated to make appointments in between the Congress to replace people or members that would have fallen away. That was done, that amendment was put in at the last Congress during the tenure of Morgan Richard Tsvangirai. Now, the president took an extra step to go to the National Council, where he got authority to reiterate and to gap fill in terms of the constitution. That's why it is more of a gap filling exercise, and the movement has been done after consultation of the National Executive and the Committee, and that is in line with the clauses of the Constitution, and that has been done above board. And the National Council, you will recall, sitting at Harvest, is the highest authority before a Congress, and it can make these decisions that will be valid up until the Congress, where they will ratify or remain the same, depending on the delegates of the Congress. So that is well within the law. The necessity to make the changes has been to be able to create a harmonious relationship and also to allow the parties to gel. There is a lot of work that needs to be done in relation to the challenges that we have as a nation, and therefore that needs a full complement, and that needs the parties moving in the same direction. So we have crossed the T's and have dotted the I's on this one. We are in the clear legally and beyond challenge. Now, the issue of the brand names, we maintain the position that our colleagues or our store colleagues did not have the authority to use the brand names in the manner that they did, and did not have the authority to use the symbols in the manner that they did. Our legal position remains valid. It remains the only legal position that has to be taken. The problem we have is that whereas our colleagues at ZEC would not register anyone else calling themselves ZANU-PF, they are all too eager to register themselves, to register anyone else who uses our names and our symbols. They not only did that for Coupe, but they also did that for various independent candidates that they allowed to get in using our names. Even the new name that we had adopted, they even allowed people to use it. That is ZEC. But you could not find them trying to allow anybody using the name ZANU-PF. So our situation is what it is. The good thing is that our voters were able to see through the shenanigans of the system, to see through the shenanigans of the various bodies that are there to protect symbols, and voted for us despite the options that were put in there. But we still maintain that no one has the right to use the brand names that we have abandoned, as it were, or have decided to show for the good of the combined opposition.
Okay, so we'll take the last round of questions.
Have you considered that ZANU-PF or any other concerned party for that matter may push for the expulsion of your members of parliament from the both houses, given that the party has reintegrated and changed its name from the MDC Alliance?
The party remains MDC Alliance in Parliament.
Our law allows for coalitions. It allows for the use of names that you elect to use as you go into Parliament. And the ownership of the MDC Alliance does not change. And the fact that people entered into Parliament as MDC Alliance does not change anything. You will recall when we entered Parliament as MDCT, our constitution still referred to MDC. If you look at it, it referred to MDC. Our constitution did not say we are now MDCT. It said the MDC. It is written as it is, and if you go to it, it is written as the MDC. But the clear ownership of that brand, MDCT, was clear that the brand MDCT was owned by the MDC, led by Morgan Tsvangirai. The brand MDC Alliance is owned by the MDC Alliance and the various principal, and it's led by Nelson Chamisa. And therefore, there cannot be any other authority that can purport in Parliament or anywhere else to act on behalf of the MDC Alliance. It's not possible for them to take advantage of it that way, or anybody for that matter, outside the MDC Alliance.
Okay, the last two questions.
Thank you. Sorry, I did not get the answer from my first question. Is there going to be an inauguration this weekend?
There will be an anniversary, and in that anniversary, there will be a number of activities that are outlined, and is outlined by the President. But the key focus of our anniversary is to celebrate, firstly, the MDC Alliance victory, and secondly, to recognize the victory of the people, to recognize what the people mandated on the 30th of July. But as to the particular details of the program, we will issue out a program of the anniversary activities at the anniversary and in due course. And you will find out with the rest of the country what will take place that day.
All right.
You've announced that the MDC now has three vice presidents. Any particular reason why there are three, considering that in the past you've seen two?
But you've also seen three in the past. Why are you forgetting that? You've had three in the past, and what we've done is simply replace those who left. You will recall that President Nelson Chamisa was a vice president, so when he got promoted to the presidency, there was a vacancy. And when Togozani Kupe left, there was a left, and those vacancies have been blocked. Let me just emphasize that you will see that some of the things that the president has had to do in the presidium was to try and cover ground in terms of gender representation, regional representation, so forth, which is why you see that Tavita Kumalo as chairperson, and that's the presidium. You have people from various regional backgrounds in the vice presidencies and the presidency. So that's the president doing a very sterling job in terms of balancing both gender and regional issues. So it just has to be done. You know, a lot of people want to be represented in the presidium, and that's probably one of the only ways you get to do that.
All right. Thank you so much for coming to this press conference. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
President Nelson Chamisa uqhakatheke ukuqhakathekisa ukuthi akhe ibandla le-MPC alibuyisele ekuqineni kulelalikho khona siqalisa ngo-1999. Sinanzelela ukuthi lokhu phezulu kukwenze ukuthi i-MDC sizaba le-19 years izelwe. UPresident ufuna ukuthi usefake abantu abavela ku-alliance ku-executive khipha njalo abanye ezikhundleni wabantuthi zikhunda ngendlela yokuthi ufuna ukuqinisa ibandla leli elungiselela ukuthi senze lokho akuthi ku-reclaima i-victory yama-elections yantshontshwa i-ZANU PF. Ngalokho upresident useappointe abantu abathize ebangenisa ku-executive yakhe. U-senator engineer Muzuri uyalokho engu-vice president. So sithi isikhundla esasinge sika-president Nelson Chamisa vice president sibakwe u-senator Komichi. Isikhundla esasinge sika-Thokozani Kupe esoku-vice president sifakwe u-professor Welshman Ncube osephendukile ku-MDC. U-honorable Tavita Khumalo okade engusikhulumeli sebandla usefakwe ku-national chairperson. U-honorable Tendai Biti usengu-national vice president. U-honorable Monzora Walengu Secretary General, honorable Mpariwa Deputy Secretary General, honorable Makone Treasurer, honorable Wende Deputy Treasurer, honorable Shibaya Remain, Walalokengu's organizing secretary, honorable Sibanda, P. Sibanda, Peggy Sibanda, usengu Deputy Organizing Secretary, his Kulumeri Sebanda, Sogungu Councillor, Jacob Mafume, isisekelo sakhe singu Dr. Regitemba Mpofu. Secretary for Elections, Moses Honorable Zuzai, Chair Lady Women, Honorable Karenyi, Chairperson Youth, Honorable Chidziva. Lezi Nyezinye Zezi, Pataman Lissis, my own president. Sessis Aotez Nyezinja, Ezi Nama committee member, Zi Gokela, Morin Kadema Unga, Gladys Tachwayo, Honorable Settlement Chikwinye, Honorable Mushoriwa, sorry, Mr. Mushoriwa, Honorable Miriam Mushai, no Uritan Dogu, Mavisitamdilo, no Evelyn Masai.
Were there any attempts to bring the candidates over?
Utozanukute wakulinywa naye kunga ngesikwenzi ukhetho kungafikile sisibanga utozanukute indaba yokuthi amabandla lafanele yavunyelana kudala ngesikhathi kwenyalana u-honorable ukhuphe ngazange avume ukungena kodwa upresident usebona ukuthi kungcono ukuthi kubekele phambili sizathola abantu bazangena kumanyano mutshalo kodwa akusiwo ozabo umakhuphe nguye labo bangabuye ukhanya ngani usethakazelela ukusebenzelana ndawonye nezanupia.
In terms of the name, are you still maintaining MDC alliance or you are going to change into MDC and Zanupia?
Ibizo leparty ngalizange lichangise lisuka ku-MDC lokhu liyi-MDC sikhathi sonke lesi ukuthi MDC team ukuthi MDC alliance bekusenziwa ngoba kulokudebiselana okubangelwa iziphathamandla zikahulumente kade zibhalisa abanye abantu ngebizo le-MDC ngesikhathi sokhetho. So lokhu bekusenzelwa kwenziwa isikhathi sonke ukuthi sizahlukanise labanye ababandabe siyavunyelwe ukukopha ibizo le-MDC.
Well, we haven't received the bill, so I don't know if there's any progress being made. But when the bill is received and agreed upon by the court and ourselves, then we will know if there's any progress.
But in terms of the monies that you guys were raising?
Fundraising.
Yeah.
Fundraising is going great.
Okay.
I think that's phenomenal. Zimbabweans are always great. They've done very well. Yeah. And then we think that they're going to do that. But I must say that it wasn't the party that was fundraising. These were ordinary Zimbabweans who were concerned about the state of justice in this country. And going to do that, and we think that it's a fantastic, it's a good thing.